Hi, and welcome to my video, How Does the Sega CD 32X Work? In this video, I will be covering the 32X hardware and how Sega CD 32X games that were released for the system work. So let's start by discussing the Sega 32X's hardware. It has two 32-bit CPUs running at 23 MHz. It has 256K of RAM. It has two blocks of 128K of VRAM that make up the 32X's frame buffer. It has an PWM audio chip and a VDP that has three modes: direct color, pack pixel, and run length. So now I'm going to quickly cover two of those modes. First up is packed pixel mode. This can display up to 256 colors at a max resolution of 320 by 240. It takes up 76.8 kilobytes of video RAM. This leaves us with some video RAM that can be used as work RAM while the frame is being drawn. Direct color, on the other hand, is a very different beast. It can display up to 32,768 colors at a max resolution of 320 by 200. You'll note that the resolution is lower, and this is because a frame at this resolution takes 128 kilobytes, the exact amount of VRAM available to a frame. I'm going to talk a little bit about the difference between a 32X cart game and a CD 32X game. A 32X cart game, the 32X has access to 256K of RAM and 4 megabytes of ROM within the cart itself. It gives approximately 4,352 kilobytes to work with. Flip side, the CD 32X is a bit more limited. It has the 32X's 256K of RAM and the Sega CD's 256K of word RAM. As we've seen previously in my Sega CD videos, there's a complex process in order to get data from the Sega CD to the Mega Drive. Data is loaded into the Sega CD's word RAM. The word RAM is flipped and transferred to the 256K of the 32X. This bottleneck may explain why we only saw Sega CD FMV games ported to the system, but I imagine its early demise and the introduction of the Saturn probably contributed towards this. It's a shame we never saw the CD32X reach its full potential, but hopefully one day we will. That's the end of this video for now. I hope to do more 32X videos in the future. If you'd like to support me on Patreon, feel free to do so. And don't forget to like and subscribe to this channel. Anyhow, I'm going to sign off and say thanks for watching, and see you next time, folks. Bye!